of Edelweiss, who tracks metals very closely for Edelweiss, joining in. Morning, Amit. So first, let's tackle steel. As Nigel is pointing out, Tata Steel and JSW are trading above their five-year average valuation. Would you touch them or continue to go for them?
Well, good morning, Atta. It's not only 5 years, but also if you look at, last 7 years or even 10 years, we have to look from that perspective. Because in last 5 years, what happens, stocks typically get re-rated and a lot of things happen. So if you consider from last 7 years or 10 years or perspective, then also they are trading at, more than that. But I would say that in case of valuations, it is very important to understand the perspective from the earnings. Now, if you look at consensus earnings for all these stocks, Tata Steel, JSW, SAIL, you name it and you have it, I mean, the consensus earnings have not been revised upwards. As the underlying HRC price or underlying aluminum price movement in case of non-ferrous would have warranted. So therefore, valuations seem to be pretty high. Now, as the street takes it into their numbers, you will find these valuations settling at a much lower level.
Okay, so Amit, morning. So, what's the point, ultimate point here on steel? To make things simple, given this massive run-up and these lofty-looking, earnings multiples, is there more space left on the upside? Do you see spreads improving? Do you see the rally continuing?
Well, again, if these kind of spreads were to be taken into the numbers or taken into by the street, then the stocks would have been at a very, very different level. So clearly, street is not considering these levels to continue. But at the same time, I would like to highlight, and we have come up with a very interesting note called Unseen Spring, in which we have highlighted three themes. One is the steel scarcity. Now, you must have never heard of this term, steel scarcity. But this is the reality now. So everywhere, steel, you are not able to find steel. So therefore, the supply crunch is there, and that is pulling the prices up. Then you have iron ore. I'm talking about international iron ore. Well, 6 months back, people were, in fact, suggesting that iron ore could go as low as 50. Now we are having it at 150. Combined with the steel shortage, you find global steel prices moving up, and therefore, Indian steel prices also typically tag along. So if you ask me, next 3 months, I see prices remaining pretty firm if these themes play out. In fact, China is another factor, but I don't see really credit tightening happening in China very soon. So you will find these spreads or these because please do remember that these spreads, these prices, these are unprecedented. You are literally in an uncharted territory. So you have never seen these prices or these spreads. So there is a little bit of, not little, there is a lot of skepticism in the street.
So Amit,
as yeah.
Yeah,
No,
so
go
we
ahead.
are running out of time, so I just wanted to sort of jump in and ask you about the non-ferrous space because we've discussed ferrous a lot. What are your top picks there and what are your target prices?
Well, so in non-ferrous, we prefer Hindalco. So we have buy on Hindalco and Vedanta. Hindustan Zinc is, of course, in restricted list. I can't comment on that. So Hindalco, our target price is 290. Vedanta is 170. And relatively, we are more bullish on Hindalco.
Right. Amit, thank you very much for that quick take. We are doing sector after sector at all-time highs to check whether there is valuation comfort. And Amit Dixit's verdict is that yes, there is, although some of the stocks are above their five-year valuation trend. Let's take a quick break. On that note, we're going to get our technical experts in, Sudarshan Sukani, Mitesh Thakkar, and Rahul Bohra.